Thanks, guys. Yeah, a full weekend of Hawkeye sports. Volleyball, basketball, and football will all compete at home this weekend.
But as these Hawkeye sports are still in season, one team season has come to a close. Field hockey fell to Penn State 5-1 at College Park last weekend, but two players earned awards for their performances this season.
Sophomore Katie Birch and freshman Maddie Murphy earned all Big Ten accolades. Birch garnered first team honors, while Murphy was named to the second team. Senior Mallory Lefkowitz was selected as Iowa's Sportsmanship Award honoree.
Yeah, Birch earns the second All-Big Ten honor of her career. The sophomore was the Big Ten Freshman of the Year and a second-team All-Big Ten selection in 2016. Birch is one of two sophomores and four underclassmen named to an All-Conference team this season. Birch led the team with 14 goals, 36 points, and 68 shots, and she currently ranks second in the Big Ten in shots and shots per game.
Murphy earns the first All-Big Ten recognition of her career. She is one of two freshmen named to an All-Big Ten team this season. Murphy ranked second on the team with 11 goals, 25 points, and 34 shots. Murphy also tallied a team-high three-game winning goals this season.
Last Friday night, the Iowa basketball team took down William Jewell College. In the first half, the Hawkeyes looked a little rough on defense and went into the locker room trailing by 1 point, but in the second half, the Hawks were able to bounce back.
Sophomore Jordan Bohannon led the team with 19 points and 4 assists, with freshman Luca Garza right behind him with 17 points. Iowa ended up pulling away from the Cardinals, winning 105-81. Here's what the team had to say after the game.
I think we can improve a lot defensively. We gave up a lot of points in the first half on our first exhibition game, and so I feel like if we just stay connected defensively, communicate and talk and transition, then we'll be in great shape. But we got another chance to come out here and work on our game to get ready for the regular season. So I just think we're all excited. We're all ready to get out and face another good team.
We're going to continue to work defensively. We know that's going to be a big goal for us this year. And we're excited to get another chance to play at Carver this year. And against a good opponent, and excited to get back out there.
The other night, we played very well at times, and we played very poorly on the defensive end at times. But we were challenged. We were challenged off the dribble. We were challenged in transition. We were challenged on the glass by a small, quick team. It'd be kind of the same in the sense that Billy's got a lot of quickness. He's got some veterans. He's got some new guys. So he's got a good blend there, I think. So it'd be a great test for us on Thursday night, a terrific opportunity for our fans to come out and see this team play.
The Hawks are back at home tonight to host Belmont Abbey College at 7:05 in Carver Hawkeye Arena.
Another Hawkeye athlete was recognized this week. University of Iowa diver Jaya Matthews was named the Big Ten Freshman of the Week.
Matthews led the Hawkeyes against Minnesota on October 27th, posting a score of 305.7 on the 3-meter to finish third. She leads Iowa with an NCAA zone standard score of 315 this season. Matthews also registered a 278.9 score off the 1-meter to finish fifth against the Golden Gophers. Matthews is the second Iowa women's diver and fourth Hawkeye to earn a weekly honor this season.
The Hawkeyes return to action Friday, traveling to West Lafayette, Indiana, for a Big Ten duel at Purdue beginning at 4 p.m. In national sporting news, last night the Houston Astros defeated the Los Angeles Dodgers in Game 7 of the World Series by a score of 5-1.
This is the first World Series in franchise history for the Astros, one of the newer clubs in Major League Baseball as they were established in 1963.
Yeah, well, I was a little surprised that this game was not as close as the first six. I was expecting a lot of excitement, a lot of lead changes back and forth like we had seen before, but Houston dominated early on, and L.A. was unable to get anything going offensively.
Yeah, the first inning hits allowed by Yu Darvish coupled with a throwing error from Cody Bellinger gave all the momentum to the Astros, who built a 5-0 lead, and the Dodgers just could not recover.
Well, that's it for us from the sports studio. Tune in tomorrow for the final score of the men's basketball game.
And Mary-Kate Herron and Zach Mackey will break down Iowa football's matchup with the Ohio State Buckeyes. Guys, back to you.